Previously, we talked about the center of mass in 3D. So, this is a bookend, right? And so, we talked about how if you picked it up at one point and just held it, and then, you know, drew a straight line down towards the center of the Earth, and then grabbed it at another point and drew a straight line down towards the center of the Earth, and then grabbed it at another point and drew a straight line down towards the center of the Earth, that those three lines would cross, would intersect at the center of mass of this object. And so even though this object doesn't behave like a particle, that it may be twisting and tumbling and turning whenever it's, you know, chunked into the air, the center of mass will travel the parabolic path that a particle will travel. And so let's do an experiment to see that that's true. So my contention is, just by looking at this thing, that the center of mass is probably somewhere in this region here. Okay? So let's take this thing and throw it up in the air and see. And let's see if it, I'm just going to kind of, you know, tumble it. Okay? So we saw that it did in fact follow the parabolic path, and we'll do it again. Okay. Okay, now, next, let's take this marker. And one way, it's with rods, it's sort of really easy. It's like, you know, you just take this marker and balance it, if I can balance it on my finger. So the center of mass is about right there, okay? So let's take it and toss it up in the air and see how it behaves. Okay, so I'm going to take it and... Okay. I'm going to do it one more time and we'll call it a wrap. Okay, so we see that the center of mass of objects behaves as though all of the mass were concentrated at that location. And so we can apply our equations in this fashion. So... this is the utility of the center of mass. See you next time.